Yeah. Watching Tintin from Nickelodeon. This is my day at home because of the coronavirus, COVID-19. Adventures of Tintin. I like cartoons, man. I've always liked cartoons. When I was a little boy, I liked cartoons. I'm a cartoon kind of guy. Spider-Man, Batman, Shazam, Teenage Mutant, Ninja Turtles. And Andy Serkis is in here, and Andy Serkis is the one who did. And Daniel Craig, who is 007. I'm a huge 007 fan. Huge. But I mean, it's COVID-19. So I mean, you really want to get down to it. It's... PlayStation 4 is broken. I don't know if I'm getting money today. I don't know if I'm getting money next week. And I don't know if that place that fixes PlayStation 4 systems and Xboxes is going to be even open next week. I guess if we don't get money today, we're not getting into next week. The week today, child tax. So then I'll have the money to get my system fixed and. So what do I do? I'm lacing up and hunkering down and gonna watch out bad for little movies. You know, tonight's $60 million. Lotto Max. Get your Lotto Max ticket tonight. You don't play, you don't win. Simple as that. This is Tintin that I'm watching, The Adventures of Tintin. And it's directed by Steven Spielberg.
Very needed, sir. I have to say, your face is familiar. Have I drawn you before?
Occasionally.
Of course, I have seen you in the newspaper. You are a reporter?
I'm a journalist. Be patient, Snowy. Not much longer.
That three walls in under 2 seconds.
Oh, I do beg your pardon.
There. I believe I have captured something of your likeness.
Not bad. What do you think, Snowy? Where's he, Ronald?
What?
Triple masted. Double decks. 50 guns? Isn't she a beauty? That's a very unique specimen, that is, from an old sea captain's estate. A unicorn, man of war sailing ship. It's very old, that is. 16th century.
17th, I would think.
Reign of Charles the First.
Charles the Second.
That's what I said, Charles the Second. The finest ship has ever sailed a seven seas.
That's what I said, Charles.
You won't find another one of these, mate. And it's only just
three in existence.
I'll give you a pound.
Done. Gently, does it? There you go. Careful.
Big pipe. How much for the boat?
I'm sorry, I just sold it to this young gent.
Oh, yeah? Tell me what you paid, and I'll give you double.
Double?
Thanks. But it's not for sale.
Look, kid. I'm trying to help you out. I don't think you realize this, but you're about to walk into a whole mess of danger.
What kind of danger?
I'm warning you. Get rid of the boat and get out where you still can. These people do not play nice.
Wonderful. Oh, it's just wonderful. Don't bother wrapping it. I'll take it as is. Does anybody object if I pay by check?
If you want to buy it, you'll have to talk to the kid.
I see. Well, not the kid named his price.
Name his price? Oh, 10 years I've been flogging bric-a-brac and I missed naming price by one bleeding minute.
I'm sorry. I already explained to the other gentleman.
American he was. All hair oil and no socks.
It's not for sale.
Then let me appeal to your better nature. I have recently acquired Marlin Spike Hall, and this ship, as I'm sure you're aware, was once part of the estate
of the late sea captain.
The family fell upon hard times, lost everything. They've been living in a cloud of bad luck ever since. We are talking generations of drinking and irrational behavior.
I'm sorry, but as I told you before, it's not for sale. Good day to you, sir.
That young man, what's his name?
Him? Everybody knows him. That's Tintin.
What is it about this ship? Why has it attracted so much attention? What secrets do you hold?
How could you not see that fallout? Where did the cat go? Somebody's watching his house. I was gonna go look up the unicorn on. Say on the internet, not from the internet. He's going to look it up in the library.
Sir Francis Haddock of Marlin Spike Hall. The last captain of the fated unicorn. The ship set sail from Barbados in 1676 on one of the most ruinous voyages in maritime history. The ship never reached destination, attacked by pirates, all hands lost except for one survivor. When Sir Francis was rescued and returned home, he was convinced his name had been